Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Tying It All Together with EMS Charts and the Zoll Monitor. We're going to jump right into it. On EMS Charts, you'll import from page 8, so you want to make sure you're on page 8, the activity log. Then we're going to take note of our at patient time or our on scene time because we're going to want to reference this later when we look at our trends. Then we're going to come down to the EKG import button. This is what we use to import the Zoll data into EMS Charts. When you click it, you'll be presented with a screen with all of the data that's been updated within your agency. You'll see the device number, the patient name if inputted, and the power on time for the Zoll monitor. Here we see the one that corresponds to our 1559 on scene time, so we're going in here. Here you'll be presented with two blocks of information. The top is called events and has to do with anything you may have inputted into the monitor in terms of the vital signs, power on, power off, as well as any markers you may have done during the call. There's often a lot of these and maybe some ones that you don't want, so you can selectively add or delete them for the import, and I recommend you do that. The second block is called reports. These are actual image files that will be inputted with your call sheet in terms of 12 leads, snapshots, maybe alarms that happened during the case where the Zoll monitor decided to save something that happened. Here, you'll generally want to deselect all of them and then reselect only the strips that you want because there can be many, in this case, 153. You'll then click import when you're ready. After some time, you'll be presented with page 8 again, where you'll see a list of all your vitals beautifully imported into EMS Charts. Please note that you'll still have to do the qualitative stuff by yourself. The numbers will be there, but you'll have to select the heart rate method, the EKG interpretation method, and the rhythm, as well as any other vitals that, of course, won't be seen through the monitor. If you happen to import the wrong file, there's no problem. You can just go down to the Undo EKG Import button, and it'll remove everything you've done. Going to page 9 now, I want to show you something about those reports at the bottom. You'll see here that there's a number of files attached, and if we view them, we'll see the zip file that contains the entire case, which can be seen on the Zoll data viewer. You can then delete any files which you may have erroneously selected previously and don't want included in the case. And then on the left side, you'll see everything that's been included. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this helps you out.